And finally, let's go to Boris Johnson's Britain, which is gripped by multiple crises as cold weather draws near.
Brexit Britain, running on empty.
A winter of discontent with a frozen government.
Plenty is going wrong. Gas and electricity prices are through the roof. Energy companies are going bust. Supermarket shelves are empty. And there are fistfights at service stations as motorists queue for hours to fill up their petrol tanks. So, what has gone wrong? Waking up in Australia last week, Nationals Senator Matt Canavan was convinced he knew the answer, blaming those empty shelves on Britain's move to renewable energy.
Net zero emissions.
In fact, almost everyone agrees the food and fuel crisis is caused by a lack of truck drivers, thanks to COVID and to Brexit, which has seen thousands of Polish drivers who used to work in Britain go back home and refuse Boris Johnson's offer of three-month visas expiring at Christmas.
Now I only drive in Poland. I do not want to work abroad. I do not think anyone would want to relocate for 3 months just to help the British sort out their Christmas.
But that is not the only thing going wrong for Brexit Britain, as you can see from these before and after headlines in the Daily Express. Like this one from 2017, ridiculing the danger to farmers of leaving the EU.
Idea that farming will collapse after Brexit is absurd.
And this one from 2021, recognising the stark reality.
Farming disaster. Brexiteer admits many farmers will go out of business due to EU exit.
And on a roll, Twitter user The Atomic Cat reeled out many more examples from Little Britain's right-wing tabloid. On fishing, before the break.
Brexit Britain to take back control of its fishing waters.
And after it happened.
We didn't vote for this. Fishing collapse as UK firms go bust and exporters flee to EU.
And on food prices, before...
Why food bills in Brexit Britain will only get cheaper.
And after...
Food shop alert as your supermarket bill set to soar due to EU red tape.
And it was also making promises on mobile phones, telling readers in 2018 that it was a Brexit lie to say Brits would be hit with roaming charges in Europe. So you can imagine the alarm at this story in The Express just weeks ago.
Vodafone brings back shock EU roaming charges and the price won't please customers.
No doubt Brexit campaigners are largely to blame for these false promises, but The Daily Express was a rabid supporter of getting Britain out of Europe and barracked tirelessly to make it happen. It's no surprise, perhaps, to discover a British tabloid can't be trusted, but it is sobering to see their errors back to haunt them so quickly and their clear lack of remorse for pushing propaganda to the public. And we wonder why people don't trust the media. That's all from us tonight.